Good afternoon, friends, and welcome to the technical presentation track. I am pretty sure that you would have had a good lunch, and it's pretty, very difficult to actually keep you awake now, but that will be what we'll be trying. And for that, we have a very interesting session, Change Management, a Success Story in the Government Organization, which will be presented by Ms. Sundari and Mr. Ashutosh Pandey. Ms. Sundari has a post-graduation in management and over 35 years of experience in software designing, development, and testing. She is currently heading the PMO, all of us know Project Management Office, Software Engineering and Process Group, in addition to the Quality Assurance Division of CDEC Noida. She has been instrumental in getting CDEC attain its level 5 certifications as well as ISO 9001 certifications. And she has been a guiding force behind many national and international paperworks. So let's welcome Ms. Sundari. We also have Mr. Ashutosh Pandey with us, who is incidentally MS in cyber law and has a total work experience of around 8 years. He is a project engineer with CDEC Noida. He's also registered as appraisal team member of the Software Engineering Institute, as well as held CDEC along with Ms. Sundari in attaining level 5 in February 2011. He's a member of Computer Society of India, and his research interests include object-oriented software engineering and software testing. Let's invite Mr. Ashutosh Pandey and welcome him on the stage. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am here to present the change management which we have done in our organization, how it has become a success story that I will just explain you. The main agenda. I'll give you the introduction. Then what are the challenges we have faced in the government organization? And the change management model which we have adopted, how we implemented the change, and analysis of the result after the implementation, and the conclusion. The concept of change management is familiar one in most of the business today. We are always, there is a change is required when we are doing something. Otherwise, monotonous work will not work. So the change management is familiar one. Any change initiative is steer the organization from away from its currently headed and enhance an improved future. There is a change, organization change is something occurs throughout an organization life cycle that is imminent. Change in the organization is required to demand the globalization, ever-changing technology. Now we see how, what are the challenges we have faced in our organization. There is a various mega software project. The planning itself is more complex. During the planning, we face a lot of problem. Initial problems were like the time schedule, and with little time, we have to deliver a lot, and there is no defined requirements because the users are not accustomed to the computerization, the old type of work they were be doing. Mostly we used to do the computerization in the government organization. So a lot of problems we used to face it during the implementation of the software projects. Specification changes during the project implementation were the frequent and inevitable, because that is some during the starting of the initiation of the project, some nodal officer will be there and we will be working with him, and suddenly after 6 months or 1 year he will be changed. During we have designed and developed the software, and while we are going for the user acceptance testing, new officer would have been there and he will be asking so many changes in the software, because his perception, his way of working will be changed, and he will be asking, and the entire thing we have to do it again. The scope creep will be there, and then schedule we will used to miss it. This was the challenges we have used to face it in the government organization. So we have to adopt some strategy to change these things. We have been working on the work mechanism and organization structure and human behavior. These are the change management main item. And the work mechanism, we have to do some procedures, methods to attain a better performance. That is why we have gone into the CMMI framework to have the procedures and methods to have a definite way of, because we are a R&D organization also. We have so many R&D projects which has to come into the CMMI framework. Then we have thought of changing the organization structure, because now present structure will not fully need of the customers and as well as the users. So we want to change the organization structure, decided to change the organization structure. Then there is a human behavior and organization cultural has to be changed. We have trained the managers, employees, lot of training and right sizing has been done during this period. There are so many change management models. There is Lean's change management model, McKinsey's 7S model, we all know very well, Kotak's 8-step change models. We have been studied these change management models. Each models we have go through it, and what model which is to our culture, organization culture, suits, then we have to choose that. We have chosen the advantage of Kotak model are that the process is easy step by step, and the focus was preparing, accepting and not actual change. The transition from one organization structure to another organization was very easier. So we have thought of going into the Kotak model. These are eight steps are there. First is we have to create an urgency in the organization. That is, we have to change. The old methods will not work. So we create the urgency. Then we have built a team. We have chose SAPG as a team for changing the change with the management to perform the change management. Then vision has been created. Short-term goals have been set. And we have been stayed with that goals. And we continually make the change permanent. These eight steps we followed and make the changes. The organization structure was built around the domain areas. We have a lot of domains in our organization, that is language computing, health informative, e-governance, and VLSI design, embedded system, all the different structure was there with domain areas. What the project teams were around these structure, that is domain areas, that if e-governance project comes, if four projects are there, then four project managers will be there and four teams will be formed inside that domain. What has happened because of this, that number of workforce has to be increased. If suppose architect has to be in that design architect, then he has to be in there in each project. Then we cannot share them. Usually what will the project manager will see the team. If he has allotted, then he will not like to share to the other team. The knowledge has not been shared. And we face the problem of this kind of managing the team. It is proposed to change the organization structure from project-based. Because that was a project, but we wanted that a matrix. That is design group separate, then development group separate, testing group separate, and implementation or deployment, which has been user interface group is separate. From the project base, the matrix base has been, we thought of going into the matrix base. Now I am handing over to Ashutosh. He will explain you how we have done.
Thank you. You will find that why madam is taking the previous sessions and why I am taking the this session. Because as a manager, she was there to make the changes, and as a team member, I am here to adopt the changes. So I also faced some challenges, and our organization may have faced some challenges, and we adopt the challenges and we get benefited from that. So what were the challenges? So our project documents, like our design documents, our review reports were prepared just after the activity phase is over, and we were doing because for the sake of our being of at CMMI level 3. So similar modules, functionalities developed by the number of projects, but components developed under one project were not being reused by other projects. We were having same kind of projects, same product, but we are doing different projects, but we were developing, but not using in other projects. There was a, because of this, there was a lot of rework in projects, and more efforts were there. and individuals and teams were continually reinventing the wheels. They are continuously doing the things, but they don't know that these things are already created in the organization. So our previous structure was like that. Our project managers were involved in bringing the projects and categorizing the requirements and making the SRS. And our design team was doing informal and formal reviews, and defects will be given in that. And this SRS and GAD, the gap analysis document, is again flowed to the design team. And the design team makes some design documents, and the review defects given to development team to design team. And the same process goes on. At this time, we were at CM level 3, but we were having lots of different projects also. So what we are gaining, what we are lacking? If we say we are gaining or we are growing, we are having extra number of delivery dates, we are having extra number of efforts, costs, site defects was getting higher, and rework was also getting very, very higher. And the main things which we have to gain was getting lower. Reusable components, in case of review defects, we are getting lower and lower. So at this time, we are at level 3, but we have to achieve the level 5, and we were having lots of other businesses also, and one more loss was there. The project, at that time, it can be easily seen on project manager's head, they were having their hair loss also. So to prevent that hair loss, our company evolved some internal changes at functional level because the opportunities were there. So first step toward the change was to identify the group which will implement the change. There is a saying by project manager generally says, project to bahut hai par karega kaun? So that kaun has to be decided. So what we did, we found a group, software engineering project process group, that was formed with the representation from different technical groups. And putting people at the top of agenda with planning to enhance staff performance because here is a function for CON has become the key element for the strategy. And as the ma'am told, previously we were working as a team. Everybody doing everything. The specialized member was doing the designing also. They were doing the development also. Most of the time they were testing the things, and they were involved in implementation kind of things also. As we have seen in previous structure, when we deliver the things to the client side, each person from the requirement team to design team, one from development team, one from testing team, has to go on client side after deployment. And the defects which we are getting from the client side is reassigned to those things. And the whole team was deployed on the client side, and everybody was busy. So this was leading these kind of issues like delivery effort and cost. So some changes has to be prepared. So implementation of change management, so this has helped in pooling the skills. Especially this last point, change in the organization when we are going to make some matrix level changes. So this was going to affect the whole organization. Approximately 300 of the employees and 50 members from middle management and top management. So what our HR and our SEPG group did, they had helped in pooling their skill and talent in a group with a clearly defined roles and responsibilities that if this is a design expert, he has to do the design only, development only, implementation only, testing only. And the documentation, the most lagging part, the documentation has become the must for other group before they start the work. And one common repository system was made, as we were at CM level 3, so configuration management was the major part, but it was being followed in different projects. So organization-wide, a central repository system was created by the QA group for the easy handling of the documents from the various groups, and some core library of the reusable components were created. As we saw in our Cotter's theorem, that some encouragement has to be given to the employees, so lower level staff. So some award point, some reward points also given, so that they got encouraged to make the changes. Baseline documents were uploaded in the project repository for the stakeholders. So new project leaders, which were getting ready, they can easily take the that documents from the core library, and they can use in their projects. The vertical function group and horizontal project team matrix helped to speed up the implementation. So this was the plan only. So this is our new structure. We have combined all the projects in some new structure. Now the higher management is involved in only bringing the projects, and one group PMO has been formed. That PMO maintains all the project-related activities, and the PMO identified some project leaders, and those project leaders were trained in stats areas. They were doing some significant project development kind of things also. Now they were preparing the whole requirements. 5-6 projects were combined into one, and they were preparing the whole requirements. So one product document has been prepared. And that product document goes to the design, core design team, and that core design team gives a design document to the core development team, and the review defects, the review process, we made one more change, we strengthen our review process. Then the design documents has been given to the core testing team for making the test cases in advance, and we created this development team, give the code and build for executing the test cases. And review defects and defects were being logged in a same common database. And the build has been finally delivered to the implementation team, the most capable team, and this team is being employed on client side only. And now the changes, small level of changes, small level of problems, small level of defects are getting cleared then and there only. So by using this particular matrix and methodology, we have reduced our rework, we have reduced our implementation cost, we have reduced our client-side defects, and we have increased our review defects so that we can make our quality better. We have also increased our reusable components. This also lowered our rework effort, and we have also reduced our delivery time also. But there was many problems. People were saying we are going to be private instead of the sarkaris. So initially, the change made the structure did not go well in between the groups, because they were their groups had been changed, their bosses have been changed, their favorite team lead team members have been changed. So there was many problems. So there were some barriers created between the groups, leading to the watertight compartment kind of things prepared. And as I was also part of the testing and QA team, so no accountability was felt by design, development, testing team, because everybody is blaming on each other's. So implementation, but the problem has to face by implementation team, because they were only dealing with the customers. So the implementation team always faced the pressure from the clients. So how to overcome these issues? As we saw in Kotter's theorem, we have to stay persistent. So mitigation, how we did the mitigation? That SCPG group has identified the project management office, PMO, to coordinate with the different groups. One group was made. The PMO tracks the timeline and progress of the project and gave a good support to the implementation team. Now the implementation need not to go like a postman to each vertical, say what's going on. The PMO is doing the same kind of thing. Weekly meetings were conducted by the PMO with the team leads of the different groups, and the targets, the agenda, the change requests were discussed in the meeting, and the next deadline was fixed in the meeting only, and they were fixed for the setting the things very as early as possible. And what the QA team was doing? The QA team was much more involved in data collection of effort, data collection of schedules, cost, number of bugs, and deployment were collected from different projects. With those collected data, we made the data analysis, and we calculated the efforts, schedules, cost. These things are calculated. And after 1 year, we found a drastic changes in our calculation. So very first change, people say, if you want to see your quality, see your customer face. So our customer satisfaction was very first taken, and we generally take our customer satisfaction within 1.5 years, and after when we deliver some project also. So previously, when we were following our project-based matrix, our customer service representatives was very frightened to go there on client side, because customers were every time having some problems. But when we applied this, our matrix-based structure, we found that our customer service index is above 3. What was the benefits of the change management? We saw that the cost of implementation of projects lowered. and against size was compared, the reusable components, rework, defects detected before delivery and after delivery, we calculated all these things. So reworking also reduced due to number of reusable components. We created a large number of reusable components that are still being used in our different projects. The defects rate after delivery was also declined, so now people can easily go to the client site. There are some data taken from our project management site. When we were using our project-based structure, these are some of our projects. These are some confidentials also. So within 1 year, this data has been collected and compared. When in case of the PGI, when we were doing the project-based structure, we have completed only 728 number of size and only 45 number of reusable components we have created. And 340, near about 1 year, we have wasted in reworking. But when we use this our matrix-based structure, the improvements you can easily see. Here, our rework has been reduced. And you can see our reusable components, 124, 76, 49, 29, these are different. But here in project-based structure, there can be redundancies also. Now we come to the cost of the implementation. In the same has been calculated for the 1 year. And when we saw in PGI, GNCDD terms, the redundancy rates were very high. Defects detected before delivery was lower, and defect detected after delivery was higher. So when we use our matrix-based structure, we have already detected defects in our system. And when the project went to client side, we had found that there are lesser number of defects after delivery. And the redundancy level is also drastically reduced. So we can see our implementation cost has been also reduced to very much. And by analyzing this data, we have found that we have close to 40%, approximately 40% cost has been saved by using this matrix-based structure. So the conclusion, the organization is now able to achieve the milestones leading towards processes and performance improvements. We have defined some of our organization goals, which we can now easily achieve by using our matrix-based structure. And this resulted in the client and employee satisfaction. Both are satisfied now. The change has been minimized project risk also, and accelerated project benefits and optimizing current and future processes. So now that con has been changed. Previously it was project to bahut hai par kare con, but now the project managers are asking project lene kon jayega. So there are lots of changes. Thanks.
Thanks a lot, Sundri ma'am and Ashutosh. And from my side, the key takeaways definitely is the hair loss treatment, which Ashutosh talked about. I had definitely come to you after the sessions, and also the Kotas principle. If I may ask Mr. Basu Datta to come on stage and hand over the mementos to our speakers.